Hi, I'm Karen.
And I'm Zach, and welcome back to another awesome episode of the Control Cabinet Classroom. Today, we're going to clarify a source of confusion for some of our customers, the difference between supplemental and branch circuit protection.
Yeah, Zach, that really is a question that comes up all the time from our customers. Here I have two breakers. One is a branch circuit breaker, and one is a supplemental breaker. Can you tell the difference?
No, I cannot.
Well, Zach, that's what we're going to talk about today. So, of course there are differences, otherwise we wouldn't be here today. And while you can see there are some physical differences in the way they look, this one has an extra bracket on the end to allow for extra spacing, what really matters, however, is how they are rated by UL.
Yeah, and it all starts with UL. And UL is an approval body that defines applications and use types for breakers. And it's important that you follow UL or you'll be sorry.
Huh?
Yeah. It's important to understand the difference, though, in all seriousness, because both devices are UL approved, but very differently, and selecting an incorrect breaker is very dangerous.
So let's first talk about supplementary breakers. These devices are recognized by UL, and you can see that by looking on the side of the device, and it has a little U with a backwards R. That tells you that this device is only approved to protect one circuit within a panel. It is not meant to be a standalone unit.
And now moving on to branch circuit breakers, these are UL 489 breakers, and they are UL listed, which you can see here, UL with the US underneath. There is the approval sign for UL listed products. So the difference here is that the UL standard will cover a little bit more when it comes to the UL listed 489 breakers because they're protecting multiple units, right? So you could use a 489 breaker, a branch breaker as a supplementary breaker, but you can never use a supplementary 1077 breaker as a branch breaker.
So to illustrate this concept, we're putting together a little demo with dominoes.
And thank goodness I brought my dominoes with me today.
Thank goodness.
Okay, so we have this set up now. And in this demonstration, we're showing a branch circuit breaker up here. Protecting two separate elements in the field. In this case, they're both M guards. And then we're also showing that the branches are coming off into individual supplementary circuit breakers, protecting each device as well. So what happens is if you have something upstream, an event that happens, the branch circuit breaker will protect both branches here. So Karen, why don't you disrupt? There we go. We're protected from the disruption in the field. It's protected both sides. But the supplementary, again, only being one-to-one, we're only going to protect each individual slice here of the circuit going into the branch circuit breaker. So Karen, why don't you make another one? There we go. Again, protected the single device here, remembering that the branch circuit breaker allows you to branch off to multiple devices. The supplementary circuit breaker acts as a supplement to that branch, protecting a single device downstream from it.
All right, so let's review. With branch protection, a breaker can protect an entire system as a standalone unit and multiple circuits, and this breaker is UL 49 listed. With supplementary protection, the breaker only protects a single circuit within a larger system and is only UL 1077 recognized.
So hopefully that helped out with some of your questions. If you like this video, please give us a big old thumbs up, branch out and smash that subscribe button, and make sure you like our video so you can see all our new videos as they come out. We'll see you next time.